Wait. Okay.
All right. One, two, three, four. All over the place. That's where he's going. Thanks.
Okay, they're not going to take this next one, so don't worry about it.
Oh, thank God. Can I just go out then while you do it?
What?
I'm just going to sit. They're not going to take it. You just do it.
I was born at 12:30, almost 1 in the morning. I was born at 1:30, almost 2 in the morning. But when the red light comes on again, Billy won't choke his hands up and he'll play the song perfectly for himself and for me.
Oh.
I was born at 9:30, almost 10 in the morning. Singing in my this day, sweet rose blossom when I smile, but my soul is stormy and my heart blows wild. Where might my lonesome lover be?
Going to ask you how the album's going,
Peter. Going very well, actually. I feel that now we've got the last couple of tracks that fit in the puzzle. We've got Natalie on the tracks that I wanted her on and got her to sing a couple of the songs that for so long I've found have been exactly what I wanted her to sing. And now we've got that, I'm very, very, very pleased about that.
Have you decided what you're actually putting on the album?
Yeah, I think I'm going to sort of put on one of those sort of birds and ships, probably. I would like to go on there. And then the Way Over Yonder that we've got with Natalie singing and proving there's nobody that kind of sings like Billy Bragg. That makes me, fills me with joy.
The birds are singing in your eyes today. Sweet flowers blossom in your smile. The wind and sun are in the words you say. Where might your lonesome lover be? Birds may be singing in my eyes this day. Sweet flowers blossom when I smile, but my soul is stormy and my heart blows wild. Where might my lonesome lover be?
We're going to call the album No, we haven't got a name. We haven't got a name for the album. No, yeah, no. We're working on the idea of calling the album Mermaid Avenue.
Oh, Mermaid Avenue.
Mm. Which is a place in
Coney Island.
Coney Island that
Billy lived.
Woody
Billy
Guthrie.
Lived. And he was Woody.
Look, you do the singing, I'll do the interviews. All right, that's the deal. Okay. Stop doing it! Stop it! I'm trying to talk in me film. I'm going to be on BBC Two, and you're going to be eating the fleas off my eyebrows. Think about it. You're not at home now. Behave.
Okay. See, ain't nobody that can sing like me. Ain't nobody that can sing like me. We'll be under in the minor key.
Ain't nobody that can sing like me, Nat.
The problem is all the ends of the lines. But let me check.
Yeah, by the end of the song, I've done the E rhyme so many times. Don't blame me. Blame Woody.
Woody has also kind of a slightly kind of grey area with his treatment of women, doesn't he?
Well, from what I hear,
He didn't believe in a conventional monogamy.
No, he didn't, no, no. And I think he was, it's part of this kind of like, rover, kind of like get rambling, gambling kind of figure that's very, I think it's very big in the American psyche, that, you know, is in the old folk songs, but also is, in some ways, you get that feeling, you know, it's the trucker tradition, you know, sort of a girl in every town, that kind of travelling round thing.
Mm-hmm.
Woody did in some ways exemplify that, which was in a bit at odds with the political stance that he kept. But he did write, you know, for some kind of pro-feminist songs, like She Came Along to Me, where he says in the song that, you know, that none of this could ever have been done if the women hadn't entered into the deal like She Came Along to Me, and those kind of songs. It shows that he had an understanding of those kind of things. But, you know, like all great artists, he couldn't keep his dick in his trousers.
I don't seem to have a problem with that personally, but I must not be a great artist. This old mountain,
it's been waiting. No, please, please.